This is Michael Kowalski, writer and performer of Mothman, True Story, and you are listening to the Unbelievers Podcast. I know you wouldn't like it.
There were several groups. One of the principal ones was the reptilians from the Iran complex.
Without any exaggeration, it was like being on fire inside.
Rats were eating you up inside.
This stuff was in my mouth. It felt like it was 500 degrees. It was unbelievably hot.
My first question would be, were you a member of the Church of Satan, a card-carrying member of the Church of Satan?
I don't understand.
There's always an argument for no reason. You know, just because somebody can fake something doesn't necessarily.
We found a life form, and that's when I started shitting my pants.
So for the person who called, I am carrying an alien.
An alien baby, and we covered right here, okay?
Okay.
Something is happening. What is it? That's the question. So do UFOs exist? It depends on what you mean, exist.
Ghosts, the spirits of humans who have passed on that manifest in the world of the living, often captured in photos, video, audio recordings, or first-hand sightings, leading many to conclude that this is proof of life after death. But what happens to non-humans when they die? Do they come back as well? Tonight, we get to the bottom of that question with two remarkable tales of ghostly hauntings that are 100% not human. Are we talking demons? Animal ghosts? Plant spirits? Of course not. That would be ridiculous. So join us now for a mashup of two of our favorite things ever as we talk alien ghosts. Right here on the program, where you continue to learn to unlearn everything you know!
Hello and welcome to the Unbelievers Podcast. I'm your host, Rus Ryan, and joining me as always is my co-host in California, Drea Mora. Hello, Drea.
Hi.
And in New York City, our soundboard engineer and producer, Rob Okey. Hello, Rob.
What's the term you use? Extraterrestrials?
Indeed.
Yes, that's the term. Hi.
What's up, guys?
How you doing, Rob?
What's going
on? So, Rob, now in New York City, I heard you got a new roommate today.
I did. A new feline roommate. Well, she's been my roommate for like 9 years, but she just moved to the new apartment with me, so I'm officially moved into New York.
Oh, boy.
That's nice of her.
Now, cat in the big city coming from Long Island. Now, I will say that there are no EVPs in this episode, so the kitty is safe for tonight. Remember, don't play EVPs for your dogs or your animals.
Oh, yeah, no. Don't do that.
She's far away from the headphones anyway. She's hiding.
Thank God.
But I don't know. She still might not be safe with what we're talking about tonight.
Because
this one's a little extra weird. Tonight, we're talking alien ghosts.
Wow.
That's the song Alien Ghost Maneuvers. Look, it was hard finding alien ghost theme music. The song Alien Ghost Maneuvers from the band Flametal, which is a mashup.
What?
It's a mashup of flamenco guitar and metal.
Okay. I see it.
I don't know what's going on with that song, if that was just like a delay in the connection, but it sounded all over the place time and
It's once. A new style. Flametal.
Good and, shit.
Now that you say that, I can hear it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's not the only strange mashup on the roster for tonight. Tonight, we'll be talking about strange accounts of the ghostly variety, but not the normal spooky apparitions like the Blackwell ghost or the floating shirts. We're going to be discussing alien ghosts.
Oh.
Ghosts of alien beings from other worlds or dimensions that now haunt the earth. Exciting, yes?
Yes.
Yes, exciting. Very yes. What the hell? So this is supposed to be aliens that have supposedly then died here and left their imprint, their energy imprint here on Earth, or the
I mean maybe
ghosts of
that are,
maybe
wow, I'm so confused.
maybe it I don't is, know or maybe they died in space and their ghosts are in space. Who I don't know.
We'll find out.
I don't know why. Just
we'll find out. I think.
Oh, well, let's find out.
What's like Flametal? We'll figure it out. So we're gonna start off by talking about a very interesting haunting by an alien ghost from a place known for dead aliens. Of course, what place is known for dead aliens, guys?
Area 51?
Yeah, Roswell, New Mexico.
Oh, thank God.
Yes.
I got it right, you guys. High five. Thank
Congrats.
You.
Congrats. Yeah, if you're going to look for an alien ghost, Roswell, that's probably the first place you look. That's your best bet. We know there was a dead alien there. So the story?
Oh, at least one, yeah.
There's at least one. It's maybe he's a ghost. So we're going to see the story of the Roswell alien ghost comes from a man a man named Jim Mars. This is a guy I respect a lot. I'm sure you guys have heard of Jim Mars. He was a journalist and writer. He's the guy who wrote the book Crossfire that the Oliver Stone film JFK was based on. Yeah, Jim Mars.
Oh, definitely, yeah.
Yeah, very, very cool. Yeah, he also wrote that book Alien Agenda, and he was a professor who taught a college course on the JFK assassination and UFOs.
Okay.
It's two different classes.
Okay.
This dude's an unbeliever.
Yeah, JFK UFO. If that was one class, that's a weird mixing of conspiracies. It's not as natural as, say, alien ghosts.
Well, just slightly less.
Well, you know what else Jim Mars is really well known for?
No. I wish I knew.
Wearing hats. He was a hat guy. And that is what he talked about on Coast to Coast AM with George Norrie before talking about alien ghosts. Here now is Jim Mars in his hat.
Police reporter, I'd run with the cops, and I'd wear a trench coat and a hat, and occasionally I actually stuck my press card in my hat, just like the old movies.
The only hat I ever wear now is my scrambled eggs, either a USS Missouri cap or my Harry S. Truman Navy hat, and that's about it for me.
Well, I have one of those that says the Hunley. SS-1, Submarine Service 1.
That went back way back.
That goes way back. If somebody asked me if I was on the crew, I said, no, luckily I was a substitute.
The Hunley, guys, that's some great military history humor.
Oh, yeah, man. I got it immediately. Totally.
So relatable.
A bunch. Yeah.
No, what the really unrelatable part? What kind of hat is George Norrie wearing? Some about eggs and
scrambled
America?
Eggs? Your,
yeah, scrambled eggs. What the fuck is that?
What soundboard one? What kind of hat does he wear?
The only hat I ever wear now is my scrambled eggs.
Okay,
scrambled eggs.
There you go.
I've got to see this hat.
That's the Photoshop challenge of the week. I want to see George Norrie wearing
scrambled eggs hat. Yeah.
Just made me think of Frasier.
Look,
I was thinking. I was like, maybe it's like a Frasier. Maybe it's really likes Frasier, so he wears his Frasier hat, which says
it's on the Frasier.
Toss salad and scrambled eggs on it, and he just shortens it up.
I think I would rather wear a tossed salad hat than I would rather wear a scrambled egg hat.
Yeah, you would.
And I was so busy with alien ghosts, I don't know what the Hunley is either. So I'm lost on all these hats.
That's true.
I'm glad I'm not the only one.
We'll get the eggs and the Hunley out of the way. I just wanted to play that for some dumb reason. But now it's time. It's going to be all alien ghosts at Roswell time now. Let's hear about it.
Alien ghosts at Roswell, huh?
That's right. Well, let me set the scene for you here. And about a month or so ago, I was in Roswell, New Mexico, and we needed an old hospital. Well, we found it in what is now the New Mexico Rehabilitation Center, okay? Now, this is out on the outskirts of Roswell. Actually, it's on what used to be Walker Air Force Base. That was closed down in about 1967 and sat idle for a while, and then the state of New Mexico picked it up, and it is now a rehabilitation center for people there in New Mexico. Before it was Walker Air Force Base, it was Roswell Army Airfield.
Exactly.
And of course, that name has now become quite infamous because of the Roswell crash, or crashes, of 1947. Okay, now as the story goes, and as I detail in my book, Alien Agenda, alien bodies were recovered and initially taken to the Roswell Army Airfield Hospital before being warehoused in one of the base's hangars. And rumors have it that at least one of these aliens may have been alive and then died while at the hospital.
All right, so this New Mexico Rehab Center that's around now, this was originally the Army Airfield Hospital where these dead Roswell aliens went. This is the same one from Alien Autopsy. It's got to be.
Yeah.
Sounds like it.
That was my first thought. I mean, obviously, my mind's going to go immediately to whatever I have in my memory, and that was the most recent, but I mean, that makes a lot of sense that they would have actually died there.
Well, so yeah, so if they did die there. Now, it's not the same building, though. This is just the current site. That thing was torn down, but this building is on the same spot. They built it right where the alien was. Yeah.
You know, this so far, this makes sense.
It was Jim Marr's guy. Yeah, he's an investigator. So he goes and visits this alien haunted rehab, and he was allowed to film and talk to staff members, and he was told the following.
Y'all told me the same story. They've all heard these stories. For years now, they said that particular wing in the hospital is haunted. They said people have encountered spots of intense cold, that the elevators will come up and open up, and nobody's there. They'll close and go down. There's nobody there. Doors open and shut. Lights come on and off. And that at night, in the quietness of the late night, they can hear footsteps moving around up there. But every time they send maintenance people or security people up there, there's nobody there.
Yeah, the footsteps is the creepiest. And with this in mind, there's a lot of activity here. But it could just be regular ghosts. I don't know. The footsteps, I don't like them.
Yeah, that was actually one of the first thoughts when you know, just even thinking about the concept of alien ghosts. Like, we have so many different types of paranormal encounters with ghosts, you know, human spirits or entities, what have you, that, oh my God, bringing aliens into the mix? That's a whole nother level.
It's really weird to think that there could be little alien, like the little grays. Imagine ghost versions of them. Usually there's like a pack of them. There's like four or five of those guys running around.
Oh, God.
So like a whole crew of little alien gray ghosts running around. That's what it sounds like was going on.
And you need to look for like ghost reports in like Virginia or other places where they have, you know, Roswell type things happening. Who knows? Who knows?
But like Hopkinsville, like you don't even know. Like those could have been ghosts.
Yeah, I think we might have to talk about that later. I'm pretty sure that hell yeah is on that trail. But this story continues.
Hell yeah.
It's pretty wild, Jim Mars.
Pretty wild enough. But then they said that there are people who have actually seen apparitions in that hallway. And these go back for years. These go back into the 60s. And they say that they have seen a little figure down at the end of the hallway.
In small figure, they weren't talking human, were they?
No. They say it looks like an alien.
Yeah, see, now it's cited. It's not just like hearsay. They are literally seeing ghosts of alien, Roswell aliens.
God. It's scary enough to see a human or like a person apparition. Like,
They get those too, so they can actually differentiate. Mars, he was able to get a lot of people to open up to him here about these strange happenings and these little ghost aliens. It's like this story.
For example, Mr. Ann told me that they so many people had seen this thing, they actually put a name to him, okay? They call him Mr. Scratch.
Mr. Scratch. How'd they come up with that?
Well, I don't know, other than we all know that Scratch is one of the nicknames for the devil, right?
Yeah.
Mr. Scratch. So then I was speaking to one of the maintenance workers. I wasn't trying to lead him in any way, so I said, well, David, let me ask you something. I said, have you heard any stories of strange, unusual happenings around the hospital here? And he kind of laughed. He said, oh, you want to know about Mr. Scratch? it's like an open secret. Everybody there knows about it, but nobody really wants to talk about it.
Yeah, new alien character, Mr. Scratch. You know, there's like Rock and Freddy. Now Mr. Scratch is there.
Mr. Scratch.
The way he presented it was like, yeah, you know, it's the other word for the devil. Like, I've never heard that name.
I've heard that name for the devil. Yeah, they've called him Old Scratch. That's it.
Is it a regional thing?
Yeah, I think so. I think it's probably some.
I mean,
thing.
It probably goes back to people being like scratched by demons, probably. I don't know. I'm just pulling that out of my ass, but it's probably something to do with that.
Well, scratch your ass, because that sounds like it makes a lot of sense to me.
Yeah, maybe the alien's like scratching himself, but they call him Mr. Scratch. They don't tell, you know, we're not hearing a lot of information here about Mr. Scratch, but that's a cool name. I like that. That's in the lore.
What do you imagine? Like, what do you think of when you think of like a gray alien named Mr. Scratch? Like, what does he look like? What does he have dressed going?
Well, I imagine somebody scratching their neck like a meth head or like a tweaker, just like scratching.
Oh, yeah, he's a tweaker.
Yeah, okay. I feel like he's got a mustache, but it like doesn't grow in all the way. It's like he's just like on the edges of his lips. Right. He's one of those mustaches, and that's Mr. Scratch, man. He's just like kind of like a sketchy alien. Can't really trust him.
Well, let's see. There are some more stories about him, and one of the people Jim Mars meets is a former nurse who had heard the stories of Mr. Scratch. And this lady's father had actually worked as a photographer contracted by the base that was part of the alien recording.